Blackstone Publishing presents My Almost Flawless Tokyo Dream Life by Rachel Kahn. This book is read by Adenrele Ojo. To Zenobia and McLovin. September. Chapter 1.
Keep your head down, stay quiet. In 10 minutes, it will be over.
Easy, easy. Easy,
the boys at the back of the bus chanted. My bad luck that the initials in my name, L. Zollner, made me too easy a target for unoriginal bullies. A sharp pencil hit my neck and then fell to the floor behind me. I heard Redmond's voice say,
"Damn, I was hoping it would catch inside her spider web of frizz hair."
Ha, the joke was on him. My hair was indeed frizzy, but it was so dirty that anything thrown into it would have no scientific option other than to slide down, the result of that one shower a week rule. Today was my 16th birthday. While other girls probably wished for a driver's license or a new outfit or a later curfew, all I wanted was to be clean. Sucked for me that this year's birthday fell on a Tuesday. Wednesday was shower day. Of course, foster home number 3 parents always denied to my social worker that the shower was off limits to me except on Wednesdays. If I had a phone, I could secretly record them talking about it. But why bother? Then I'd probably be sent to an even worse home. Foster homes number 1, lice, and number 2, bedbugs, had been bad enough. But number 3, overlords who were mean and liars, was the worst. I didn't want to know what could happen at number 4. The devil you know is better than the one you don't, Mom always told me. Mom was raised in foster care. She would know. She tried for better for me, and until the car crash 2 years ago, she'd succeeded. She had a job. We had a nice, small house. There was laughter in our lives. A cat. Then, after the car accident, the beast moved in and took over. He wasn't someone I could see or talk to. The beast was addiction. And thanks to that beast, my mom was now in prison. Was Mom keeping track of time? Did she even remember today was my not-so-sweet 16? If I had a phone, I knew I'd see a dozen emails, texts, gifts from Reggie, my best friend from when we were both on the swim team at the Y, wishing me a happy birthday. But he also didn't have a phone and was stranded at a boys' home across the county, another foster care victim. Not victim, he'd hate that word. I'm a survivor, Reggie would say. His mother had also been an addict, but she never made it to prison. She died from a fentanyl overdose. Despite my miserable situation, I was still incredibly grateful that my mother was alive. I knew how lucky we were that Mom's problem took her to jail rather than a graveyard.
Hey, smell bomb, turn around when you're addressed by your superiors.
The latest taunt came from Jacinda Zubrowski, who sat 2 rows behind me on the bus and 2 seats behind me in homeroom, and never failed to comment on my smelly secondhand clothes. The poor kid sitting next to me, I didn't even know his name. He was some scrawny freshman who looked about 12, slid closer to the window. Smart move. No reason he should be brought down with me. Then he scrunched his nose and said, on the down low,
"There are showers in the gym locker room, you know." Little jerk.
I knew. I was hardly going to further expose myself, naked, in a public high school locker room. I'd rather smell bad.
"Anybody hungry for some mixed nuts?"
A male voice, one of Redmond's friends, asked, and the back of the bus group laughed. What a not clever way to speculate about my heritage. My mother was part Irish, German, African-American, and Native American, but the shape of my eyes and my cheekbones indicated my biological father was Japanese. I'd never met him, didn't even know his name. Mr. Tokyo, Mom called him. He was probably married like all of Mom's other boyfriends. Married men were her primary weakness, until she was introduced to painkillers. One of those men had been driving the car when they got hit from behind on the beltway. He died. Mom suffered severe spine injuries. That's when the beast took over.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.